Hello everyone, good day. Welcome back to the Ecotourism Journey channel. This is Paul. Thank you very much guys for watching my videos and for patronizing the Ecotourism Journey. If this is your first time visiting in my channel, please click subscribe button below now. Kindly click also the bell icon so that you will be notified for the new uploaded videos. This video is an instructional resource in response to the new normal of delivering academic requirements. In this lesson, it emphasizes the history, culture, and tourism in Region 7. Likewise, this is one of the course intended learning outcomes of Philippine culture and tourism geography. What are the objectives? At the end of this lesson, you will be able to 1. Describe brief history and geographical features of Region 7. 2. Describe basic economic activities of each province in the region. 3. Introduce some tourist destinations in the region. 4. Promote tourism on a regional level. Please ensure to watch this video, learn and enjoy. Region 7. Central Visayas. This is an administrative region in the Philippines, numerically designated as Region 7. It consists of four provinces namely, Cebu, Bohol, Negros Oriental, and Siquijor and three highly urbanized cities Cebu City, Lapu-Lapu, and Mandaue. Major islands are the eponymous Cebu, Bohol, and Siquijor, together with the eastern part of Negros Island. The regional center and largest city is Cebu City. The region is dominated by the native speakers of four Visayan languages, Cebuano, Bantayanan, Boholano, and Parohanan. Province of Bohol. It is an island province of the Philippines located in the Central Visayas region, consisting of the main island itself and 75 minor surrounding islands. Its capital is Tagbilaran City. Bohol is the 10th largest island of the Philippines. The province is a popular tourist destination with its beaches and resorts. The chocolate hills, numerous mounds of brown-colored limestone formations, are the most popular attraction. History. The people of Bohol are said to be the descendants of a group of inhabitants who settled in the Philippines called Pintados or Tattooed Ones. Boholanos already had a culture of their own as evidenced by artifacts unearthed at Mansasa, Tagbilaran, and Andaus and Panglao. Bohol is ultimately derived from Bohol, a kind of tree that flourished on the island. The original name is survived through Buol, a town in Tagbilaran where Miguel Lopez de Legazpi supposedly landed. On 10 March 1917, the Americans made Bohol a separate province under Republic Act 2711, also established most of the other Philippine provinces. Geography. To the west of Bohol is Cebu, to the northeast is the island of Leyte, and to the south, across the Bohol Sea, is Mindanao. The Cebu Strait separates Bohol from Cebu, and both island provinces share a common language, but Boholano retain a conscious distinction from Cebuano. Bohol's climate is generally dry, with maximum rainfall between the months of June and October. The terrain of Bohol is basically rolling and hilly, and about half the island is covered in limestone. Near the outer areas of the island are low mountain ranges. The interior is a large plateau with irregular landforms. The province of Bohol is a first-class province divided into three congressional districts, comprising one component city and 47 municipalities. Demographics. According to the 2015 census, it has a population of 1,313,560 with Roman Catholicism as predominant religion. Boholano is a variant of the Cebuano language spoken in the island province of Bohol in the Visayas and a major portion of southern Leyte, as well as northern parts of Mindanao. Economy. The province's employment profile shows that it is mostly agriculture remains the biggest sector in the province in terms of working population and land use. The major sources of income is agriculture, that includes farming with corn, rice, banana, coconut and root crops as staple crops and fishing. Tourism plays an increasing role in the island's economy. In the coastal barangays, some are engaged in small businesses. Others are employed both in government and private sector like in beach resorts and tourism-related establishments. Transportation. The province's main airport is the Bohol Panglao International Airport on Panglao Island, serves as the gateway to Panglao Island and the rest of mainland Bohol for domestic air travelers. The airport is officially classified as an international airport by the Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines, but currently only serves domestic flights. The province of Bohol can also be accessed by boat with several shipping companies serving trips to and from nearby islands in the region. Tourism. Bohol is one of the most popular and tourist-friendly destinations in the Philippines. This island province in the Central Visayas region attracts visitors from all over the world because of its stunning and diverse attractions, with the Chocolate Hills as its most famous tourist spot. The Chocolate Hills in Bohol is a one-of-a-kind geological formation of grass-covered hills that turn brown during the dry season. Bohol is also known as the home of one of the world's smallest primates, the tarsiers. The province has a rich history and is home to heritage churches dating back to the early years of Spanish colonization. For eco-adventure lovers, Bohol offers a host of adrenaline-packed and extreme activities. But the white sand beaches, world-class dive sites and generally laid-back provincial atmosphere of Panglao Island are what give Bohol its unique charm as well as the river cruise. Province of Cebu. It is a province of the Philippines located in the Central Visayas region Valle region. Its capital is Cebu City, the Queen City of the South, the oldest city and first capital of the Philippines, which is politically independent from the provincial government. The Cebu Metropolitan Area or Metro Cebu is the second largest metropolitan area in the Philippines after Metro Manila, with Cebu City as the main center of commerce, trade, education and industry in the Visayas. Being one of the most developed provinces in the Philippines, in a decade it has transformed into a global hub for business processing services, tourism, shipping, furniture making, and heavy industry. History. The name Cebu comes from the old Cebuano, Cebu or Cebo, the place for trading. It was originally applied to the harbors of the town of Sugbu, the ancient name for Cebu City. Alternate renditions of the name by traders between the 13th to 16th centuries include Cebu, Cebai, Zubu, or Zebu, among others. Sugbu or Sugbo, in turn, is derived from the old Cebuano term for scorched earth or great fire. The arrival of Portuguese explorer Ferdinand Magellan in 1521 began a period of Spanish exploration and colonization. Arriving in Cebu City, Magellan, with Enrique of Malacca as a translator, befriended Raja Humabon, the Raja or King of Cebu, and persuaded the natives to ally themselves with Charles I of Spain. Magellan soon heard of Datulapu-Lapu, a native king in nearby Mactan Island, a rival of the Rajas of Cebu. It was thought that Humabon and Lapu-Lapu had been fighting for control of the flourishing trade in the area. Cebu, being one of the most densely populated islands in the Philippines, served as a Japanese base during their occupation in World War II, which began with the landing of Japanese soldiers in April 1942. Geography. Cebu is located to the east of Negros, to the west of Leyte and Bohol Islands. The province consists of Cebu Island, as well as 167 smaller islands, which include Mactan, Bantayan, Malapascua, Alango and the Camotes Islands, with six component cities and 44 municipalities. But the highly urbanized cities of Cebu, Lapu-Lapu and Mandaue are independent cities not under provincial supervision, yet are often grouped with the province for geographical and statistical purposes. The province's land area is 4,944 square kilometers, or when the independent cities are included for geographical purposes, the total area is 5,342 square kilometers. Cebu's central location, proximity to an unusually exotic tourist destination, ready access to a diversity of plant, animal and geological wonders within the island, and remoteness from earthquake and typhoon activity are some of the special attributes of Cebu. Demographics. The population of Cebu Province in 2015, according to the census, was 2,938,982 people. The Cebuano language is spoken in Cebu, as well as in most areas of the Visayas, including Bohol, where it is spoken as Boholano, Sikwar, Western Leyte, Biliran, and Negros Island region, especially in Negros Oriental, as well as most provinces of Mindanao. The majority of its population's religion are Roman Catholic, followed by roughly 95% of Cebuanos. Tagalog and English are widely spoken in commerce, education and even in the community. Economy. Cebum, a portmanteau of Cebu and Boom, has been used to describe the province's economic development. Over the years, Central Visayas' key city, Cebu, has grown into one of the country's most significant provincial economies and an attractive destination for foreign direct investment. With many beautiful islands, white sand beaches, luxury hotels and resorts, diving locations and heritage sites, high domestic and foreign tourist arrivals have fueled the tourism industry of Cebu, contributing the economic boom. Cebu has been one of the BPO hubs in the Philippines, particularly at the Cebu Information Technology Park. In 2013, Cebu ranked 8th worldwide in the top 100 BPO destinations report by global advisory firm Notable business districts are the Cebu Business Park, Cebuit Park, Cebu South Road Properties, Mactan Town Center, and Mandoa Reclamation Area. This area hosts industries related to the information technology industry such as shopping, tourism, software development, telecommunications, engineering research and development centers, and business process outsourcing. Cebu is also a home of the export processing zone with hundreds of manufacturing companies producing export products to different parts in world with apparels, electronics, furniture, processed foods, computer parts and other similar products. Cebu province likewise produces agricultural products like corn, rice, vegetables, sugar, and copper as well as mineral products like coal and dolomite. Fishing has been one of the alternative source of livelihood also to residents of coastal municipalities and islands. Cebu is considered as the main education hub in the Visayas with various universities and colleges offering hundreds of academic programs. Transportation. The Mactan-Cebu International Airport in Mactan Island serves as the main gateway to domestic and international routes to or from Cebu City and other islands in the Visayas region. Mactan-Cebu International Airport, located on Mactan Island, is the second busiest airport in the Philippines with various international direct as well as domestic flights. The province currently has two airstrips, one in the Bantayan Island in northern Cebu, and one in the Camites Islands on the east, both of which are being eyed for redevelopment, so they can accommodate commercial flights and boost tourism opportunities in northern Cebu. The port of Cebu is the largest shipping hub in the Visayas region with various shipping companies offering passenger vessels to any ports in the Philippines. The Cebu Ports Authority has accredited 20 seaports in the province, although many of these facilities are in need of upgrades and the necessary infrastructure to connect them to national roads. Given the fragmented nature of the island provinces of Central and Eastern Visayas, bridge connectivity is being eyed by the current administration to spur development in these regions. One of which include the project currently being built is the third connecting bridge between Mactan Island and mainland Cebu to complement the existing Ismina and Marcelo Fernan bridges. Tourism. Cebu City is a significant cultural center in the Philippines. The imprint of Spanish and Roman Catholic culture is evident. There are also many historically important sites all over the province such as Colon Street, the oldest street in the Philippines, old churches, heritage houses, and temples. Sinulog Festival is the largest festival in the Philippines, held every third Sunday of January commemorates the child Jesus, Santo Nino, the Lord and Protector of Cebu. The Sinulog is a dance ritual of pre-Hispanic indigenous origin. The dancer moves two steps forward and one step backward to the rhythmic sound of drums. The Sinulog Festival celebration lasts for 9 days, culminating on the final day with the Kadogan Sa Mactan. Literally translates to the victory in Mactan, this is a historical festival reenactment of the Battle of Mactan. Celebrated canonically on the 27th of April, it depicts the events before, during, and immediately after the defeat of Portuguese navigator Ferdinand Magellan at the hands of Lapu-Lapu and his men. Magellan's Cross Pavilion is a stone kiosk in Cebu City, Philippines. The structure is situated on Plaza Sugbo beside the Basilica del Santo Nino. It houses a Christian cross believed to have been planted by explorers of the Spanish expedition of the first circumnavigation of the world, led by Ferdinand Magellan, upon arriving in Cebu in the Philippines on April 21, 1521. Along with the Basilica del Santo Nino's church and convent buildings, the pavilion is a declared national cultural treasure of the Philippines. Beyond Cebu's historical sites, luxury hotels and resorts, vibrant nightlife, various restaurants and different cuisines, this urban destination also offers eco-adventures. Within the forests of interior Cebu, waterfalls, gardens and rare birds await those adventurous enough to seek them out. While along this 200-kilometer-long island, coral reefs virtually surround its entire perimeter as well as swim with sardines and whale sharks. It's not uncommon for one to see locals, entrepreneurial as they are tending to several businesses during the week, and going boating, mountain trekking, garden hiking and scuba diving on weekends. Province of Negros Oriental. It is a province in the Philippines located in the Central Visayas region with its capital, the city of Dumaguete. It occupies the southeastern half of the large island of Negros and borders Negros Occidental, which comprises the northwestern half. It also includes Apo Island, a popular dive site for both local and foreign tourists. History. Negros, the second largest island in the Visayas and fourth largest island in the Philippines, is believed to have once been part of a larger landmass but was cut off by rising waters at the end of the last ice age. Among the early inhabitants of the island were the Negritos and the Austronesians, and later the Han Chinese, who are mainly merchants. Spanish explorers on the expedition of Miguel López de Legazpi first came to the island in April 1565. Legazpi dropped anchor in Bohol and sent his men to scout the island. During World War II, both Negros provinces were invaded by Imperial Japanese forces, resorting many residents to flee to the inland mountains. Geography. Negros Oriental occupies the southeastern half of the island of Negros, with Negros Occidental comprising the northwestern half. It has a total land area of 5,385.53 square kilometers. A chain of rugged mountains separates Negros Oriental from Negros Occidental. Negros Oriental faces Cebu to the east across the Tainan Strait and Siquijor to the southeast. The Sulu Sea borders it to the south to southwest. Negros is basically volcanic, making its soil ideal for agriculture. 80% of all arable land in the island region is cultivated. Demographics. The population of Negros Oriental in the 2015 census was 1,354,995 people, with Roman Catholicism as predominant religion. Cebuano is the primary dialect spoken with at least 90% of the population, and Hiligaynon is also spoken by individuals mostly in areas around Basay, Bayawan, Sta. Catalina, Canlayan City and some areas in Mabinay. Economy. Negros Oriental has, for a long time, been a major supplier of electricity to its neighboring provinces in the Visayas, with its excess power capacity generated by the 192.5 megawatt Palimpanan geothermal plant. Despite the huge power excess of the province, other power sources such as hydro, wind and solar are being explored to provide additional power capacities that can be sold to neighboring areas. With its vast fertile land resources, Negros Oriental's other major industry is agriculture, with crops like sugarcane, sweet corn, coconut and rice. In the coastal areas, fishing is the main source of income. People are also involved in cattle ranches, fish ponds and rubber plantations, especially in Bayawan City. There are also mineral deposits like gold, silver and copper found throughout the inner areas of the province. Transportation. The Dumaguete Airport, located in Sibulan, is the province's only commercial airport. It is a domestic airport with multiple daily flights to and from Manila and other provinces, served by Philippine Airlines and Cebu Pacific. The primary seaport of the province is located in Dumaguete City. Additionally, there are five other seaports in the province classified as tertiary. Negros Oriental has a network of roads, including a national road, that spans the circumference of Negros Island. A large portion of residents do not own private vehicles and are totally reliant on public transport. Buses and jeepneys link the cities and municipalities of the province. Tourism. Each town in Negros Oriental celebrates an annual town fiesta, usually dedicated to a patron saint of a particular town or city. Additionally, the Buglasan Festival, which was revived in 2001, is celebrated annually in October in the provincial capital of Dumaguete and is hailed as Negros Oriental's Festival of Festivals. One of the landmarks of Dumaguete is the Dumaguete Bell Tower, which stands next to the St. Catherine of Alexandria Cathedral. It once used to warn the city of impending pirate attacks. Negros Oriental enjoys some of the island's best natural scenery and places of adventure, with plenty of waterfalls and volcanic lakes to trek to. Mount Talanus and Canlayan Mountain both offer trips to hidden calderas through outstanding tropical forest with rewarding views. Then there are the waterfalls that are just east from Dumaguete City. La Libertad is a good base for nature-based tourism also. Province of Siquijor. Officially, the province of Siquijor is a sixth provincial income class island province in the Philippines, located in the Central Visayas region. Its capital is the municipality also named Siquijor. During the Spanish colonial period of the Philippines, the Spaniards called the island Isla del Fuego or Island of Fire. Siquijor is commonly associated with mystic traditions that the island's growing tourism industry capitalizes on. History. A Siquijor legend tells of a great storm which once engulfed the region. Then there came a strong earthquake that shook the earth and sea. Amidst the lightning and thunder arose an island from the depths of the ocean's womb, which came to be known as the island. Despite being a legend, modern times highland farmers have unraveled giant shell casings under farm plots, supporting the theory that Siquijor is indeed an island that rose from the sea. The island was first sighted by the Spaniards in 1565 during Miguel López de Legazpi's expedition. The Spaniards called the island Isla del Fuego or Island of Fire because the island gave off an eerie glow from the great swarms of fireflies that lived in the numerous olive trees on the island. Esteban Rodriguez of the Legazpi expedition led the first Spaniards to discover the island. He was captain of a small party that left Legazpi's camp in Bohol to explore the nearby islands which are now called Pamilican, Siquijor, and Negros. Geography. Siquijor lies southeast from Cebu and Negros across Cebu Strait, also called Bohol Strait, and southwest from Bohol. Panglao Island, which is part of Bohol Province, has a similar composition of the soil which is found throughout the whole island of Siquijor. With a land area of 327 square kilometers, Siquijor is the third smallest province of the Philippines, both in terms of population as well as land area. To the north of Siquijor is Cebu, to the west is Negros, northeast is Bohol, and to the south, across the Bohol Sea, is Mindanao. Demographics. According to the 2015 census, it has a population of 95,984 with Roman Catholicism as predominant religion. The main language spoken in the island province is Cebuano, with Tagalog and English often used as second languages. The former is understood and used as the national lingua franca, but it is rarely used in everyday conversation among locals. Economy. The island province relies on farming with corn, vegetables and other root crops as the primary produced. Fishing is also one of the sources of livelihood income among local residents along coastal areas. Tourism in the province of Siquijor has been recognized because of its natural attractions, waterfalls, and beach resorts which can be considered as the economic drivers. Transportation. The island of Siquijor has two seaports capable of servicing cargo and passenger sea crafts plying to and from nearby provinces in the region. Siquijor also has an airfield located near Siquijor capable of handling smaller and mostly privately owned airplanes. Tourism. Despite the province's Catholic affinities, almost all of the residents continue to adhere to traditional practices that were used prior to the 15th century, albeit these practices have also adopted Christian belief systems as well. Due to the ingrained and indispensable traditional belief systems, majority of residents have continued to possess a high respect for the natural environment which was revered by the ancestors of the people. Siquijor is known for its unique Philippine culture of blending Catholicism with traditional religious practices, a major part of its people's cultural heritage and identity. Siquijor's long-time reputation as a place of magic and sorcery both attracts and repulses visitors. Siquijor is also well known for its festivals that focus on healing rituals where incantations are sung, while the old folks make potions out of herbs, roots, insects and tree barks. Among the many attractions are the beaches, caves, waterfalls, Bandila and Natural Park and Butterfly Sanctuary. The most popular of them are the Cambugahay Falls and the Old Bali Tree, both located in Lazi. The coral reefs ringing the island offer some of the best diving in the Philippines for snorkelers and scuba divers. To summarize, this video emphasizes insights on the brief history, geography, economic importance, and tourism destinations in Region 7. Specifically, this video encourages everyone to 1. Discover culture and history on a regional and provincial level. 2. Explore the geographical and topographical features of each province in Region 7 or Central Visayas region. 3. Travel domestically and enjoy the beauty of people, culture, and natural resources. 4. Support domestic tourism for cultural and economic sustainability. 5. Be proud of our own characteristics and diversity. 6. Be a responsible tourist for environmental sustainability. What can you say about this video? For further information, please do not hesitate to post insights at the comments section below. Once again, please do not forget to click like button, subscribe button, and bell icon so that you will be updated for the next uploaded videos. I wish that you were able to learn new lessons and insights from this video. Thank you very much for watching. God bless.